надо.
Hello, everyone. Jared Green, Alex O'Neill, RationalPassions.com. We both saw a little game called Cyber Shadow.
It's a video game.
That's what they tell me. I think that's what they do here.
What did you think about Cyber Shadow?
So a lot of people are using the Shovel Knight sort of example of how to turn sort of old school game design into a modern sort of reinterpretation, not just because it's published by Yacht Club, developers of Shovel Knight, but because it takes something that we clearly have seen and sort of feel. Anyone who's played video games in the past 20 years has probably played Ninja Gaiden or Shinobi in some of those, to some extent. This feels almost exactly like that when you play it. It looks a lot like it when you see it from far, but once you start playing, you kind of get that feeling like you've played this game before, but probably not as good as this.
Yeah, it's real tight. It's real polished, and like obviously the first comparison, and it's something that I even talked to the one developer about, I can't remember his name off the top of my head, of course,
Arn,
is The Messenger, which is essentially trying to fill a little bit of the same space of like, hey, we're a ninja game, 2D, 8-bit, or 16-bit side-scrolling action. And when I talked to him about it, the cool thing that he said, it was like, I think what's great is that after I finish my ninja game, I'm going to have a brand new ninja game to play.
Yeah, and it's kind of a folly to kind of make them to make the example that they're the same. The Messenger and Cyber Shadow are different.
Yeah.
The only thing they have in common is that they're ninja games.
Yep.
Where Cyber Shadow is way more run and slash and throw with your special abilities. The Messenger is very much kinetic and really wants to combo with action and hopping miss jumping and all these crazy puzzles and kind of being funny. Cyber Shadow is very much not that. It's kind of like a techno future, like grim, like dark ninja
very,
story.
Very, very grim. That opening shot of like, he explained that like he becomes cybernetic, or he wakes up cybernetic, and they've shown in the trailer like him like bleeding like oil, like over the ground. It's intense.
It's a mood. What I like, I think, about Cyber Shadow the most is this sort of intention of speedrunning, right? Because Arn made a game that was supposed to look like this 3 years ago.
Yep.
And he had built sort of both his knowledge of programming and design and this game's concept at the same time. So he was learning on the fly.
Yep.
And every so often, he'd reach a milestone, and then he'd look at his game and say, I don't know if this is what I want, but we'll see. Maybe like a year ago, he kind of shut it all down and was kind of frustrated. But then turned to the speedrunning community and was like, all right, what if I narrowed my focus? Didn't try to make this game, you know, some open world Metroidvania thing. What if I just made a game you're supposed to play as hard as possible?
Yeah.
And it's something, that sort of purity of gameplay is something that is really an identifier of why indie games are cool.
Yeah, and it's also him like taking the concept of like what Yacht Club did and kind of taking it all the way of like, hey, we have a two-button game and it's always going to be two buttons, but that doesn't mean you're not going to get all these different abilities that are letting you apply those things in way different ways. Like the one that you get in the demo we played was holding down while you're on the ground will do like this fire uppercut, which was really cool, but holding down and attacking while you're in the air will do like this down strike, kind of like in Shovel Knight, kind of like Zelda 2. And they are fully embracing like a more complex game within the kind of carapace of old school 2D game. Mm-hmm. And on top of that, he's talking about like perfect frames and skipping whole chunks of levels. Like, this is something you can do, but you need that precision, you need that excellence
and
to get there.
And it's kind of like any good speedrunner, or really any good 2D platformer, you can play it at a pretty basic or like semi-advanced level up until a point. But if you want to get really good and get really good, like the practice makes perfect, you want to like really achieve at this game, you'll be rewarded for it by just kind of the ways you can bypass some challenges or the way you can kind of find your way around things.
Yeah. It like the game that jumped on my mind that I feel like was developed almost in a similar sense is Celeste, right?
Yeah.
This is a game they intentionally could have made this something more generated that is tough and hard, but they wanted to make set levels because they wanted to see people speedrun it. They wanted people to blast through it. And Cyber Shadow has like, it's interesting to see that philosophy applied to obviously a very different kind of game. But it, like when you pick it up the first time, I feel like it's a little slow. It's kind of what you would think from like an old school Ninja Gaiden on NES, but when you start applying those things to it, you see how it speeds up and like it ramps so fast.
Yeah, he was playing some debug stuff that wasn't necessarily in the demo a couple hours ago, and that game turns into a Strider like really quick.
Yeah.
And when once you start like, compounding the abilities you can have and having him flash across the screen and like, and he was playing debug with like new abilities that you can't get in the demo in the two demo levels, and he's doing things I didn't think you could see in the demo level because he's jumping over certain obstacles that you have to do. He's beating bosses in ways you never thought.
Mm-hmm.
And that's sort of proof of the design sort of concept. Like, we played these two levels before, but you didn't play it like this.
Yeah.
And when you play it like this, you'll see some things. This level is a completely different level now.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
It's wild.
Yeah. No release date. No. Actually, Cyber Shadow is out soon.
Soon is the intent. I think summer was what they're aiming for.
On Switch. And as far as I know, that's it.
Maybe Steam, maybe coming to other things right now. Yeah. Switch, we know for sure.
About the other consoles, but Switch definitely.
Yeah, yeah. I'm really excited to play it.
I am too.
Cool. Thanks for watching, everybody. Follow us, Ratchet Passions, more PAX content. We will see you next time with more.